السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today, inshallah, we're gonna speak about the vocabulary of lesson 24. The vocabulary of lesson 24. I'm so excited to speak about it, as I do believe that most of the words are really effective in our life. Before we start speaking about the words that are existed in lesson 24, let's have a brief introduction about them. In this part, I'm gonna show you all the words, I mean the 10 words that are existed in lesson 24 with pictures and definition that shows you more about them. I hope that you understand the meaning of them and feel the meaning of them, which is the most important thing for me. The first word is the word affection. 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 What is affection? Affection is the feeling of fondness for someone or something. It's the feeling of love. It's the feeling of being affected by positive things. Affection. Look at the mother here. She's having affection towards her baby. Affection. It's the sense of love. The feeling of love. Affection. The second word is one of the best words. It's the word bond. What is a bond? The bond is the relation that has existed between you and somebody else. The relation, the tie, the link, the connection, all of these things are called a bond, okay? So what is a bond? It's a feeling of close friendship between two people, and let me say it's the feeling of the existence of, connection, link between you and somebody else. Then comes the word charge. You know, charge is to, swoop down. You know, when something swoops down, it's charge. It's to rush or to move quickly towards something. It's called charge or swoop down. The word charge has a lot of meanings, but here in the text it has only one meaning, which is to rush or to move quickly or to swoop down. Okay. Then comes the word chief. 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 What is chief? Chief is the most important thing or the largest part of something. Chief means the leader. Chief means the former. Chief means the initial or the first or the major or the main or the prime or the master or the leading or the central. Chief, the most important or largest part of something. This is one of the most important words, the word chief, I mean. Then the word companion. Companion. Companion is a close friend. This friend could be an animal, could be a person, could be something. As long as you are spending time with this thing and this thing is really close to you, this means that he is or it is a companion. So we can say that a companion is someone who spends time with you or something that spends time with you. Companion. Companion. Then the word enclosure. Enclosure. So what is an enclosure? An enclosure is an area that is fenced off and used for special purposes. You know, an area that has encirclement or surrounding or, a fence. Okay. So it's called enclosure. 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 An area that is fenced off and used for special purposes. Then the word exhausted. Exhausted. I'm really exhausted. I'm really tired. I'm having no energy. I'm exhausted. Exhausted. Then comes the word inseparable. This is a good word. Inseparable. Always together. You cannot break the tie between us. You cannot break the connection. You cannot break the bond that has existed. We are inseparable. We are inseparable. The feeling or the relation that we are having together is inseparable, unbreakable. Nobody is able to break it. Then comes the word intruder. Intruder, okay, intruder. It's a good word, intruder. What is an intruder? Intruder is a stranger, an outsider, a foreigner, a person who comes or who enters a place without a permission. He is not asked to. He comes inside without a permission. He is an intruder. Intruder. Okay? Then the last word is the word suffer. Suffer. It's to feel great pain or sadness out of something that happens. Okay? Suffer. Suffer, it's to feel great pain or sadness. I'm suffering a lot. You suffer. We are having a lot of sufferings. Suffer, suffer, it's a good word too. Now I think we are going to be able to read the words together. The first one is the word bond. Bond. Many people feel a very strong bond or connection or relation with animals. Many people feel a very strong bond or connection with animals. Number two is suffered. A veterinarian treats animals who have suffered injury or illness. Suffered. They have had a lot of pain or sadness. A veterinarian treats animals who have suffered injury or illness. Then comes number three, intruder. Remember, intruder. Animals are cautious when an intruder invades their territory. Number four, companion. A pet is usually a companion of its owner. A pet is usually a companion of its owner. They spend a lot of time together. Close friend, a companion. Then number five, enclosure. Enclosure. This ranch worker checks to be sure that an animal's enclosure is secure and safe. Enclosure, the fence, enclosure. Then the word inseparable. People and their service animals often become inseparable. Inseparable, they are never apart. Inseparable, they are never apart. Number seven, charged. Charged. This dog has charged or rushed at the ball that its owner has tossed. This dog has charged or rushed at the ball that its owner has tossed. Then number eight, chief. One of the chief jobs, the most important, the leading jobs, the most important jobs, one of the chief jobs of an aquarium biologist is to educate visitors about sea life. One of the chief jobs of an aquarium biologist is to educate visitors about sea life. Then comes the word exhausted. Exhausted. This dog walker loves his job, but he will be exhausted or worn out by the day's end. This dog walker loves his job, but he will be exhausted or worn out by the day's end. Then the last word is the word affection. This girl feels affection or fondness for the sheep on her family's farm. Affection, love, strong relation, good bond. This girl feels affection or fondness for the sheep on her family's farm. And you know the way I end my videos. Do your best, make me proud of you, and stay safe.